Well, happy Thursday. It is October 1st, and welcome to this episode of the Davecast as we continue in our study of the book of James. Today, we're going to be covering James 1, 13 through 18. So I'm just going to go ahead and read that to you. When tempted, no one should say, God is tempting me. For God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he tempt anyone. But each person is tempted when they are dragged away by their own evil desire and enticed. Then after desire has conceived, it gives birth to sin. And when it is full grown, it gives birth to death. Don't be deceived, my dear brothers and sisters. Every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. He chose to give us birth through the word of truth, that we might be kind of first fruits of all he created. And so James has been addressing these people who have been going through all sorts of trials. And he goes on in this section to talk about temptation. And of course, those believers had their specific context, but there's something universal going on here because all believers, every single one of us, will at one time or another face both those things, right? Trials and temptations. And even though some people seem to have this mistaken notion that once someone becomes a quote-unquote Christian, that the trials and temptations are going to go away, that's just not reality. Trials and temptations are part of everyone's life. But I know there are some people who think that once I'm a Christian, that all my evil desires will just leave me. And someone who is facing trials and temptation in their lives, well, you know, they're just not living right. But James is saying, no. It's just like those trials, there will be temptations. And then he goes on to explain how to deal with it. And when it comes to temptations, James is abundantly clear. Don't make this about God. God's not the one doing this to you. The origin of this is not God. God is good. But it's our nature to blame, and it comes to this free will and choice that God has given us. But oh, how we want to blame someone else. I mean, think back to that first sin in the book of Genesis. Remember Adam? He says, it's not my fault. It was because of that woman you gave me. So it's kind of your fault, God, because, you know, you gave me this woman. And then Eve's excuse, you know, what's that? It was the serpent. He made me do it. So, you know, the devil made me do it. And I found that that's pretty much our two go-to sources to blame, right? It's God's fault. Not sure what God had in mind, but one day I'll understand it. You know, it happened, so I guess it was God's will. And so, you know, we blame God, or, you know, it's the old Flip Wilson routine. You know, the devil may be to it. But James is very clear. He says, each one is dragged away by their own desires. Notice, own desires. Other translations translate that as lured. You're lured. And I actually like that better because it has this image of a fish hook, a fishing line that is a temptation. And so there's personal responsibility here. We have a choice to either take or reject the bait. And so the question is it a sin to be tempted? No, we are all tempted. It's universal. It's common to humankind. But James goes on to the next verse to imply that it's when we are lured and we take the bait that gives birth to sin. And sin, when it's full grown, leads to what? To death. And so it's a very graphic picture. But so how can we learn how not to take the bait? How can we not be lured? Well, James says, don't be deceived. There are good and perfect gifts that come from the Father. And then he goes on to say, don't be deceived. Temptation should not be taken lightly because it is the gateway to sin. I think this is the same for everybody. I found that temptation's often strongest when we're at our weakest. In fact, the longer we allow it to brew in our thoughts, the more dangerous temptation becomes. I think it's also important that we face temptations, today's temptations today, not tomorrow. I think a lot of people try to put it off and say, well, this is the last time I'll do it. But, you know, temptations come to us all on a daily basis, and God promises us to have the strength to overcome them. And James reminds us that there are good and perfect gifts that come down from God. And then in verse 18, he goes on to say, he chose to give us birth through the word of truth that we might be kind of first fruits. And so notice a parallel there in verse 18 to what we read in verse 15, where it says temptation gives birth to sin and sin to death, it's this illustration of a birthing process. And he says God's perfect gifts give birth to life. And so when temptations come, and they will come, remember it's not a sin to be tempted. But let me suggest this. Be very sure that you do not deliberately place yourself in a position to be tempted. And I don't know what that is for you. I mean, there are some temptations to avoid that I think are kind of universal for everyone. But lots of times it's a personal thing. That maybe it isn't a big deal for some, but they are for others. It's how we respond to the lure and what it leads to. For example, it's like saying, is the internet sinful? Is it sinful to surf the web? No, not of course not. You found this Bible study that way. But for some, they take that lure and they end up going to bad sites and destructive things happen. Is it sin to eat chocolate? No, but if it leads to gluttony, yes. Is it a sin to talk to your neighbor? No, but if that conversation leads into gossip, I think you see what I'm saying. You know, there are a lot of things that the devil will use, and we just need to be aware of the triggers that we have that leads us into sinful behavior, you know. So, to one, alcohol may be temptation. To another, it might be impure thoughts and acts. To another, greed, you know, covetousness, we envy. Criticism, you know, we gossip about others. But it's one big point I'd like to make. You know, it's one thing to notice the lure with the bait on it. It's another thing to go into swimming into an area where we know for sure there's going to be a lot of lures out there with bait on them. And so remember the words of Paul. He says, no testing has overtaken you that is not common to everyone. God's faithful, and he will not let you be tested beyond your strength. But with the testing, he will also provide the way out so that you may be able to endure it. Well, you know, that's it for today. Hey, I've got a great interview lined up for this Saturday's Davecast, so be sure to catch that on Saturday, and we'll be continuing in our James study next Tuesday and Thursday. And so until then, be safe, keep bringing the hope, and have a great rest of this Thursday. Bye-bye now.